Hallelujah. Christ is risen.
Hallelujah.
40 days after the resurrection of our Lord, Jesus ascended into heaven in the presence of his disciples. Ascension Day in the church year was last Thursday. Although today is the seventh Sunday of Easter, our devotional worship will focus on our Lord's ascension and the blessings he gives to his church on earth. We begin singing Awesome God, and we'll sing it through twice. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that even as we believe your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to have ascended into heaven, so we may also in heart and mind ascend and continually dwell there with him, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The readings, as we focus on the ascension of our Lord, the first one is recorded in the first chapter of Acts. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know times or seasons that the Father has fixed by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. And when he had said these things, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. And while they were gazing into heaven as he went, behold, two men stood by them in white robes and said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into heaven? This Jesus who is taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And a reading from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 24. And he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he blessed them, he parted from them and was carried up into heaven. They worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy and were continually in the temple blessing God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now, one of the things that I read with this current pandemic and isolation is that they determined that some people have had an impact, or it's had an impact on people's lives, where people, some of them are depressed, anxious, kind of beside themselves at times. I asked somebody on the phone recently how they were doing. They said, fine. And I said, but you're not climbing the walls? And they said, well, a little bit. You know, so this isolation and pandemic does have an impact. They even have children's books being written recently addressing the situation so that children can be taught about what's going on in their lives and help them to cope. Now, I don't know about you, but I love children's books. I think they have so much wisdom and so much in there. You know, when my boys were very young, you know, one of the kinds of books that we were dealing with was the Winnie the Pooh. I don't know if you ever read any of those books or saw the videos. But Winnie the Pooh, they have these characters who all live in the Hundred Acres Woods. And sometimes these characters can remind us of people we know or even ourselves at times. There is a tongue-in-cheek report by the Canadian Medical Association that sparked a widely shared theory that each Winnie the Pooh character symbolizes a certain mental disorder. And that theory has been around since at least the year 2000 when the BBC released an article. But here's a rundown of some of the disorders of these characters. They say that Winnie the Pooh has impulsive eating disorder. His near obsession with honey indicates an eating disorder, and his habit of repetitive counting shows evidence of obsessive compulsive disorder. Piglet, you know, generalized anxiety disorder. A piglet is in a perpetual state of worry and can often be heard saying, "Oh dear, oh dear." He's also developed an ear twitch, and that is common in overly anxious people. Eeyore. We all know Eeyore. He has depressive disorder. He always has a bleak outlook on life and never feels any positive emotions like happiness and excitement. Rabbit has obsessive compulsive disorder, according to that article. Rabbit is very orderly and obsessive, mostly in regard to his garden. Owl has dyslexia and narcissistic personality disorder. While he is exceptionally bright, it is frequently shown that Owl has trouble reading. An example would be in Pooh's Grand Adventure when he mistakes the words school for skull. Owl is also theorized to have narcissism, an inflated sense of self-importance due to his belief that he is wiser than others. That's just to name a few. But I always wondered and marveled how Eeyore could be so depressed living in such a wonderful place as the Hundred Acres Woods with so many wonderful companions around him. And yet, Eeyore reminds me of people. People who sometimes have anxiety, people who are sometimes depressed, and you try to minister to those needs, and sometimes you're successful and sometimes you're not. You would imagine that the disciples at the ascension of our Lord would have been depressed for having seen their Lord ascend bodily into the heavens where they would not see him bodily again until Judgment Day, that he'd be departed from them. But that's not what was going on at the ascension of our Lord. The disciples were not depressed at all. They were full of joy. And that's because of what the ascension means to them and to us. The ascension of Jesus into heaven was when Jesus sat down at the right hand of God, and it was not a specific seat where he would be retiring from his labor, but it was a position of power and authority. Jesus once said to his disciples, "All authority has been given to me, therefore go and make disciples." And that authority given to me is in heaven and on earth. That means all powers are underneath the authority of Jesus, even the authorities that you find in your life and in Washington and all over the world. It's all subjected to Jesus. He is at the right hand of the Father in that position of power and authority over all dominions. And that's a source of joy. And what is he doing? He's blessing his people. As Jesus led his disciples out to that point where he would be ascending into heaven, he lifted up his hands and he blessed them. And while he was blessing them, that's when he was departed from them, as if he is in a continual state of blessing. And he is blessing his people, his church, blessing us with his presence in our lives. He's blessing us with his forgiving grace through word and sacrament. He is blessing us with a peace with God in our lives, peace in our hearts, peace in our minds. Because Jesus is in that position. He's not there to make life easy for us. He is not there to bring heaven onto earth, but he is there to bless his people, knowing that he is in the position of all power and authority over all things. And that means he is one to whom we can go to and pray and draw strength from in our lives. And not only is he blessing us, he is that source of joy. The gospel reading, St. Luke says that they were filled with joy at his ascension. And they returned to Jerusalem with joy. And that joy can be ours today as we are reminded about our Savior, where he is, who he is, and what he's doing. And he's doing a lot for you in your life. You may not always recognize the wonderful things he has in mind, but he is there to help you, to sustain you, to bless you, and to be with you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through faith in Jesus Christ. Amen. The flowers on the altar are given by Mr. and Mrs. Craig Bergeron in honor of their 20th anniversary and all their blessings. The eternal light is lit by my wife and myself in memory of our mothers. And for the prayers, Sue Cosgrove requested prayers for the men and women who have given their all defending our country. From Jan Kirby, for Patty Scanlon, recovering from surgery, and for Roger Conway under the doctor's care. And from Beth Sienna to pray for Katie under the doctor's care. From Sue Brady to pray for Russ under the doctor's care. And from Tracy Becker to pray for her niece Tiffany and her family who are struggling with some difficult family decisions. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, you are in the position of all power and authority over all. Help us to look beyond the earthly matters and to trust in you for all things. We offer our prayers for those who are ill, lonely, or depressed. If it is your will, bless them with healing, companionship, and peace. We pray for those who mourn. Comfort them in their sorrow and give them strength. Bless our families in their isolation, that they may find ways to strengthen the bonds of love and fill our homes with your presence and peace. Help us all to be thankful for the blessings of family and friends. And hear the prayers we offer to you within our hearts and minds in this moment of silence. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Almighty and merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you. Amen. Our service concludes with the singing of Crown Him with Many Crowns, verses 1, 4, and 5.
Thank you.
your day.